Good morning. Welcome to the Town of Fort Mill's annual Memorial Day program. We are honored and thankful to pay our respects for those that have served and sacrificed their lives for our country and our freedom. I am Gwen Savage, the mayor of Fort Mill, and I would like to introduce some special people today. We have Senator Michael Johnson joining us, Town Council members Lisa Cook, Alan Garrison, Ben Hudgens, Ronnie Helms. We have the Mrs. South Carolina Strawberry Queen, Christy Ativer. We have the pageant co-director, Janine Bentz. And we have our town manager, Davey, raise your hand. Hey, Davey Broom. We have our rec director, Brown Simpson. Jacana Hester, our events planner, Chris Sardelli. And Sheriff Kevin Tolson. So we have a wonderful group of folks today. If I had all of your names, I would read them because I know only special people come to special events. So thank you for being here. We will now begin our program with a prayer by Councilman Ben Hudgens.
Heavenly Father, we pause in reverent silence to honor those brave souls who sacrificed so much for our nation's freedom. We thank you for this day to honor all of those through their courage made the ultimate sacrifice by giving their lives for our country. Please bless all their families with comfort and peace as they remember those who were lost. I thank you for our ability to gather here freely, and I pray that you will carve their sacrifices into our hearts so we may never forget the loss of those heroes. We also ask that you bless everyone gathered here today and give us the strength to rise to the challenges of our time and meet them in full faith that you will always be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Ben. Now we will move to our Pledge of Allegiance with Alan Garrison, a council member as well. Alan?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I think I see Debbie Cloninger has joined us as well. Debbie, welcome to our event. Now, we will have what is some of the most favorite parts of our program to me. We will have the national anthem, Star Spangled Banner by Lily Lee, 16, of Catawba Ridge High School, and Lacey Lees, 14, of Catawba Ridge High School. Thank you, ladies.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red flare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
What a beautiful rendition of our Star Spangled Banner. Thank you, ladies. That was really nice. Well, all right. Typically, I will look up a favorite quote or something that seems appropriate. This is my eighth time speaking, but today I decided to read a poem. I will appreciate your patience, but it just spoke to me when I read it last evening. A soldier died today. He was getting old and paunchy, his hair was falling fast, and he sat around the Legion telling stories of the past. Of a war he had fought in and the deeds he had done, his exploits with his buddies. They were heroes, every one. And though sometimes to his neighbors his tales became a joke, all his Legion buddies listened, for they knew whereof he spoke. But we'll hear his tales no longer, for old Bill passed away, and the world's a little poorer, for a soldier died today. He will not be mourned by many, just his children and his wife, for he lived an ordinary and quite uneventful life. He held a job, raised a family, quietly going his own way, and the world won't note his passing, though a soldier died today. When politicians leave this earth, their bodies lie in state, while thousands note their passing and proclaimed that they were great. Papers tell their whole life stories from the time that they were young, but the passing of a soldier goes unnoticed and unsung. Is the greatest contribution to the welfare of our land a guy who breaks his promises, or lady, and cons his fellow man? Or the ordinary fellow, in times of war and strife, goes off to serve his country and offers up his life. A politician's stipend and the style in which he lives are sometimes disproportionate to the services that he gives, while the ordinary soldier who offered up his all is paid off with a medal and perhaps a pension small. It's so easy to forget them, for it was so long ago that the old bills of our country went to battle, but we know it was not the politicians with their compromise employees who won for us the freedom that our country now enjoys. Should you find yourself in danger with your enemies at hand, would you want a politician with his ever-shifting stand, or would you prefer a soldier who has sworn to defend his home, his kin, and country, and would fight until the end? He was just a common soldier, and his ranks are growing thin, but his presence should remind us we may need his like again. For when countries are in conflict, then we find the soldier's part is to clean up all the troubles that we politicians start. If we cannot do him honor while he's here to hear the praise, then at least let's give him homage at the ending of his days. Perhaps just a simple headline in a paper that would say, "Our country is in mourning, for a soldier died today." I can't take credit for that poem, but it says so much to my heart and to everyone that has served and made us free. So, with that, we will now move to probably the most important part of our program, and it's the reading of the soldiers that have died and are given to us by name. So we will begin with the names. Sergeant James Eli Bales, World War I, 118th Regiment, 30th Division. Staff Sergeant Rule K. Boone, World War II, 330th Bomber Squadron, buried at Normandy. Corporal Sam Henry Boyd, Vietnam, 173rd Airborne. Staff Sergeant Thomas M. Bradford, awarded 2 Purple Hearts, 8th Air Force, U.S. Army, World War II. Private First Class Clinny E. Brown, World War II. Private Earl C. Coffey, World War II, killed in action. Technician 5th grade Douglas N. Cranford, missing in action, Africa campaign, World War II. Sergeant James B. Dunn, World War II, died of wounds. Private Thomas D. Irvin, World War II, 30th Infantry Division, Sergeant Void L. Fail, killed in action, World War II. Private First Class Charles Reginald Farrell, Purple Heart, killed in action, Vietnam. I will now turn this over for Lisa Cook to read the names that she has.
Thank you.
Staff Sergeant Charles Melvin Good, Vietnam 1st Infantry Division. Thomas L. Hall, World War I, Medal of Honor recipient. Private First Class James H. Harris, World War II, killed in action. First Lieutenant James Mack Harris, killed in action, buried at Normandy. Sergeant Jerry Donald Helms, Vietnam. Private First Class Roy Franklin Howington, 1st Marines Division, killed in action, Korea. Captain James M. Johnstone, Vietnam. Sergeant James O. Lamb, World War II. Walter O. Leeser, World War I. Lance Corporal Raymond Irving Long, 1st Marine Division, Vietnam. Private First Class William J. McCammon, 2nd Infantry Division, World War II. Seaman First Class Kenneth L. McKenzie, World War II.
Ben?
Alan.
Oh, sorry. Now, no. Alan Garrison will read his list.
I'll just take this with me.
Corporal Harvey F. McManus, Company G, 118th Infantry, 30th Division, killed in action, World War I. Lieutenant Samuel L. Meacham, Jr., plane crash in Wisconsin, World War II. Private Fred T. Miller, died in France in World War I. Private First Class Shelley H. Mullis, 101st Airborne Division, World War II. Private Odell S. Myers, 100th Infantry Division, 397th Regiment, World War II. Captain Douglas H. Nims, 117th Infantry, 30th Division, World War II. Private Charles R. Pettis, he died on Leyte Island in World War II. Lance Corporal Freddie Joe Pfeiffer, killed in action, Vietnam. Fireman 2nd Class Olin Phillips, died in World War II in the Philippines. Private 1st Class Johnny Wiley Potts, he was the only black soldier from Fort Mill who died in Vietnam. He was killed in action. Seaman 2nd Class Johnny L. Privet. He was served on the USS Sims. He died in the Battle of the Coral Seas in World War II. Specialist Lawrence Edward Scott. He died in an accident in Vietnam.
Councilman Ben Hudgens.
Seaman Robert W. Self, World War II. First Lieutenant David Wesley Smith, Vietnam. Samuel W. Smith, Jr., U.S. Navy, World War II, lost at sea. Private Nathan T. Steele, World War II. Sergeant Frank B. Steele, killed in action, World War II. Private First Class Lyndall Ray Steele, in Vietnam. Clyde W. Stevens, World War II. Seaman First Class James G. Summer, World War II, missing in action. Robert Taylor, World War II. Lieutenant Charles A. Turner, U.S. Navy, World War II.
And now our Mrs. Strawberry Queen, Christy Ativer, will read the remaining names.
These names were submitted by our community. Fort Mill High School graduate, Special Javian S. Sullivan, born February 5th, 1993, and died in Anbar, Iraq on January 8th, 2018 at the age of 24. U.S. Army First Lieutenant Noah Harris, he gave his life at the age of 23 for his country on June 18th, 2005 in Bakuba, Iraq. Harry J. Bible, Private First Class Infantry. He died while serving in Italy, May 1945, and was a World War II Bronze Star Medal recipient awarded for his heroism. Captain Ted J. Taylor, U.S. Army, killed in action, Republic of Vietnam, July 1971, from Beaufort Community, Lancaster County. U.S. Air Force Master Sergeant James McGahee, U.S. Air Force Master Sergeant Doug Lacey, H.E. Milligan, missing in action, Korean War.
Thank you all. I know that there are many of you here today that are related to the names that we have read. So many of those names are older Fort Mill families that each of us grew up with children or grandchildren of those that gave their lives. So thank you for being tough today in this whiplash weather and coming out to join us to pay our respects. We will now have special music, Hey Brother by Tiffany Jensen, high school homeschooled student.
Helps us honor and grieve the losses of the past and look forward to the future. God bless you and God bless America.
Thank you. Good job. What a nice job. Now, very fortunately, I'll be turning over all the way up to the adjournment, the process of our program to the American Legion. How can we have an event without the American Legion? They are stalwarts. So let's give them an incredible round of applause. We love each and every one of you, and we're grateful not just for your service, but for what you do for our community. So I'll turn that over.
Good morning. I'd like you all to please rise if you're able to, for the laying of the wreaths and the rendering of honors. They're gonna lay the wreath with Carolyn Rawlins, Jane Gray Smith of the Ladies Auxiliary, American Legion, Post 43. Ladies. We now have the rendering of honors to rifle volley and taps. Sergeant at arms, render honors.
Right.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Well, I might have to wing it at the end here. But that's not so bad. We would like to thank each and every one of you for the sacrifices that you make daily to keep our country free. The town would like to thank you for coming out in this weather. You have an indomitable spirit. Normally, we have people passing out from the heat. Today, we needed coffee. I don't know. It's just the South, right? We hope that each and every one of you gathered something from your experience with us today. We as a staff and council and all of our elected leaders here, we never forget. And we hope that you will have gathered something from this presentation this morning that you too will carry with you. Thank you so much for joining us. We try to have a short but memorable program so that you can move to a day off. Thank you, staff. Thank you, Tony McMahon. We couldn't do anything without your expertise in saving these images and this video for us to view for those that couldn't attend today. And with that, I wish you all a happy Memorial Day. May God bless.